Hallelujah. John 14 chapter, verse 16, 17, and 26.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Have Vickers, please say amen. And I will pray the Father, with Jesus speaking, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because they see him not, neither know him. But you know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. Then verse 26, but the comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I said unto you. And I want to deal with tonight understanding what the Holy Spirit brings. Understanding what the Holy Spirit brings. Understanding what the Holy Spirit brings. And thanks to God, I think that we need to get an understanding of what the Holy Spirit brings into the house of God, but not only in the house of God, but in our personal, individual lives. The Holy Spirit has been so misunderstood in the house of God, and we have labeled the Holy Spirit just being power, and not understanding that the Holy Spirit is a person, that the Holy Spirit is part of the Godhead, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. But saints, I think in the house of God that we have really shut the Holy Spirit out. And we have allowed flesh to come in.
My God.
Where when the Holy Spirit wants to move or the Holy Spirit wants to speak, we shut the Holy Ghost down. And we allow flesh to begin to speak.
Yes.
We got music, but there's no Holy Ghost.
My God.
Preaching, no Holy Ghost. Shouting, dancing, no Holy Ghost. Trying to live holy, but no Holy Ghost. And this is the problem, because if the Holy Spirit is not in the equation, then the power of God will not be there for us to be victorious.
Yes.
And something that the enemy wants us to do, he wants us to shut out the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Now, since God, the Bible tells us, quench not the Spirit of God.
Yes.
Because he's a person.
Mm-hmm.
We don't quench. Quench means to extinguish.
Mm-hmm.
It's like that fire extinguisher over there. We use that to put out fire.
Yes.
If a fire happened, we would use that to put the fire out.
Right.
Well, the Bible said, do not quench, do not extinguish the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Which means do not put out the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Sometimes we suppress. Quench means to suppress.
Yes.
Sometimes we suppress the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit would speak, we suppress him. When the Holy Spirit will heal, we suppress him. When the Holy Ghost would move, we suppress him. Because sometimes we try to make the Holy Spirit be on our program instead of us being on the Holy Spirit's program.
Yes, yes, yes.
Everything has to have an order to it.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes God can't move because of our program.
Oh, yeah.
If God want to move in Sunday school, then we let God move in Sunday school.
Mm-hmm.
If God want to move as soon as we come to the door, we let God move as soon as we come to the door.
Yes.
If God want to move while we in the parking lot getting out the car, we let the Holy Ghost have his way.
Yes.
As soon as we get out there in the parking lot.
Come on.
We don't quench the Spirit of God.
Yes.
Because we have too many churches quenching the Spirit of God.
Yes.
It's not the Holy Ghost speaking, it's us speaking.
Come on.
It's not the Holy Ghost moving, it's us moving.
Yes.
It's not the Holy Ghost shouting, it's us shouting. Do you hear me?
Yes.
But we cannot quench the Spirit of God. When God tells the praiser, we quench the Holy Spirit. We extinguish the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
God said, lift your hands. We don't lift our hands. You know why? The Holy Ghost want to leap in your belly. But you don't even know it. We quench him when God tells us to lift our hands and praise him. We quench the Holy Ghost when God said, lift your hands and thank me.
Yes.
We quench the Holy Ghost when God said, begin to worship me.
Hallelujah.
And we don't even understand that we are quenching the Spirit of God.
Mm-hmm.
We quench the Spirit of God. When the Holy Ghost want to speak to us, we quench him. We suppress the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost cannot speak because we are suppressing him.
Yeah.
It's certain thing that the Holy Ghost would say, but we don't let him say it. It's certain thing the Holy Ghost would do, but we don't let him do it. Do you hear me? The Holy Ghost want to do so much more in the house of God, but we keep on suppressing him.
My God.
We suppress the Holy Ghost.
My God.
Oh, my God. We quench him when he's trying to move and when he's trying to speak. When the Holy Ghost said forgive, we quench him. We shut him down. When the Holy Ghost said walk in love, we quench him. We shut him down. When the Holy Ghost is speaking through the pastor or whoever's up speaking, guess what? We quench him. We shut him down. You know why? Because we don't want to do what the Holy Ghost say.
My God.
And when you reject the counsel of the Holy Ghost or reject the moving of the Holy Ghost, right then, you just suppress the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
But thanks to God, we cannot be a church that suppress the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
We cannot be a church who put out the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Let's let the Holy Ghost have his way in the house. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Let's let the Holy Ghost have his way in our own personal life.
Yes. Lord, thank you, Jesus.
It's one thing to let the Holy Ghost have his way when we come into the house of God. But it's another thing for the Holy Ghost to have his way when you leave outside of the house of God.
Yes.
A lot of saints, we are major on letting the Holy Ghost have his way when we come into the house of God. Mm-hmm. But we are not major in letting the Holy Ghost have his way when we walk outside those doors. The same thing that the Holy Ghost said when we was in the house of God is the same thing that the Holy Ghost means when we walk outside the house of God.
The same
thing that the Holy Ghost said while we was in the house of God is the same thing that the Holy Ghost means when you get back to your house. Do you hear me? We don't suppress the Holy Ghost and we don't put out his fire. We don't shut down the Holy Spirit when he's speaking.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
And we have a people that's quenching the Holy Spirit. This is the reason why we don't see the healings and miracles in the house of God. It's because we are quenching the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit has a ministry in the earth realm. Do you hear me? Saints of God. He has a ministry inside of the house of God. The Holy Spirit has a ministry in your own personal life. I want to be led by the Spirit of God.
Yes.
To his men are led by the Spirit of God. The Bible said these are the sons of God.
Yes.
We can't say that we're sons and daughters of God if we're not led by the Spirit of God.
Come on.
We got to quit questioning the Holy Spirit. The Bible said don't grieve the Holy Spirit because we were sealed with the Holy Spirit. Grieve means to make sad. Do you hear me? Grieve means to cause pain, cause emotional pain. When we grieve the Holy Spirit, how do you grieve the Holy Spirit? You grieve the Holy Spirit when the Holy Spirit tells you to do something and you disobey him. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Right then, you cause the Holy Spirit to be grieved on the inside of your spirit.
Yes.
And sometimes we grieve the Holy Spirit. We disobey God, and in turn, we grieve the Holy Spirit. We don't listen to what he has to say. But saints of God, we got to get back to understanding what the Holy Spirit, what the Holy Ghost bring into the house of God. If we understood that he was there to help us, we would not reject him. And if we understood that he is just not some force, that he is just not power, but that he is a person who got all power. Do you hear me? We treat the Holy Ghost like he just power. All the Holy Ghost are moving. All the Holy, but he's just not power. He's a person. Look at John chapter 14, verse 16. And I will pray the Father, and he should give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Now that word another do not mean different. It means of the same kind. Jesus said, I'm going to get ready to go, but I'm going to send back the Holy Ghost, and he's of the same kind just like me.
The
Holy Ghost is no different from Jesus.
Yeah.
They just have different operations. Do you hear me? The Holy Spirit is no different from the Heavenly Father. They just have different operations.
Yeah.
He said, I'm going to send back another of the same kind. I'm going to send back a helper unto you. He said, I'm going to send back a comforter. He said, I'm going to send back somebody to aid you. Do you hear me? Thanks to God.
Yeah.
And we need the Holy Ghost to aid us in this Christian walk. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
We need the Holy Ghost to strengthen us so we can walk upright before God. Do you hear me? You need the Holy Ghost to comfort you in the late hour when you're going through trials and tribulations and going through the storm. It's the Holy Ghost that was speaking to your spirit and said, God has not given you the spirit of fear, but the power of love and of a sound mind. Why? Because he come alongside to aid and assist you. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
It's the Holy Ghost
When you're going through trials and tribulations in your lifetime, you can't sleep. If the Holy Ghost there will tell you, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Do you hear me saying to God? It's the Holy Ghost that will tell you that peace have I given unto you. Not as the world given, but as I give it. Peace will surpass it all understanding. It's the Holy Ghost that will begin to tell you when you sad with sorrow. Do you hear me saying to God? It's the Holy Ghost that will tell you, listen, that the joy of the Lord is your strength. Yeah. And in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. Do you hear me say, God? It's the Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost.
That begins to speak to us in our late hour. It's the Holy Ghost. When don't nobody know what's going on. And we come into the house of God. And our heart is very heavy with trials and tribulations. It's the Holy Ghost that will speak through that vessel and give you a word and help you to come out of that dark state. Yeah. It's the Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost.
Jesus said, if I do not go away, the Holy Ghost would not come.
Oh,
why? Because Jesus had to go back and sit down on the right hand side of the Father.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
When he made it back to heaven, the Holy Ghost took off and came in earth for him. Do you hear me? The Holy Ghost is a helper.
He's a
comforter. Mm-hmm. He comforts us. If we just will listen to him, the Holy Ghost will comfort us. Sometimes we can't be comforted because we don't listen to the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't wonder why come. I'm so depressed. Because you ain't listening to the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
The Holy Ghost is the fire of God. That's how come the Bible said, Jesus said, you're going to be baptized with Holy Ghost and fire. The Holy Ghost is the fire of God. He is the consuming fire of God. Do you hear me? The Holy Ghost is the breath of God. All I need is the breath of God blowing in my life. Do you hear me? The Holy Ghost is the wind of God. God, let your wind blow in my life, oh God. Do you hear me? We need the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is omniscient, which means that he is all-knowing. The Holy Ghost is omnipresent, which means he's everywhere, is all time. The Holy Ghost is omnipotent, which means that he is all powerful. Do you hear me say, God? We need the Holy Ghost.
We need the Holy Ghost. Yes, Lord.
My God.
Thank you, Jesus.
The Comforter, which will abide with you forever.
Forever.
Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because they see him not. Baby, cut their own. Neither know him, but ye know him, for he dwell with you and shall be in you.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, I told you in the Old Testament, the Holy Spirit came down on people. He empowered them to carry out certain tasks. But we get over to the New Testament, the Holy Ghost just don't come on us. He come and live down on the inside of us. Jesus said that the Holy Ghost should live down on the inside of you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That you are sealed. The Bible said you are sealed. The Bible said you are sealed with the Holy Ghost. Seal means to put a stamp on somebody.
Uh-huh.
How do God know that you healed? Because you are sealed with the Holy Ghost. When Jesus will come back and rapture the church, the reason why come you're going to go up is because you are sealed with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
That's the mark that's on you. That's how God is able to tell that child is mine. Do you hear me? Because you are sealed with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
This is the reason why come we don't grieve him. Come on, saints of God. You got to get a good relationship with the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
God, listen. God said you are sealed with the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my God. And the Holy Ghost should be in you. Oh my God. God, I want the Holy Spirit down on the inside of me.
Down on the inside.
Look at verse 26. Oh my God. Thank you, Jesus. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. That's John chapter 14, verse 26. Which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name. He shall teach you all things. And bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I said unto you. The Holy Ghost just don't come for all power. But the Holy Ghost also comes to teach.
Yes.
And a lot of us need to be taught.
Yes.
But when we do, we quench the Spirit of God.
Uh-huh.
When the Spirit of God is trying to teach us, we reject the teaching of the Holy Spirit. God is trying to teach you. But you keep suppressing the Spirit of God. You keep quenching the Spirit of God.
Yes.
When you come into the house of God and the pastor is preaching, right then the Holy Ghost is speaking. But some of us, what we do, we quench what the Spirit of God says. We suppress what he says. Therefore, we stay bound.
Yeah.
An outer anointing of the Holy Ghost.
Mm.
And there is an inner anointing of the Holy Ghost. Go to 1 John. I want to show you something. 1 John, the second chapter.
Mm.
Yes, Lord. If I get there before you, I'll just take off.
Hallelujah.
1 John, the second chapter.
Thank
I want to teach you right, thanks to God. The 27th verse. Thank you, Jesus. Oh my God. That's what I'm called to do.
Oh, yes.
To give you the word. Yes, Lord. Line up on line. Precept on precept. No error. Do you hear me, thanks to God? Look at verse 27. But the anointing which you have received of him, do what?
Abide
in you. That's the Holy Ghost living on inside of you. And you need that not any man teach you, but the same anointing teach you all things. Okay, what do the anointing do? It teaches all things. The Holy Ghost is just not raw power. But he's a teacher. Do you hear me say to God? I need the Holy Ghost to teach me. He said that the Holy Ghost is going to bring to your remembrance the things that I said. The Holy Ghost do not say what he want to say. He don't understand what Jesus already said.
Come on.
When we hear preaching today, we're hearing everything except for what Jesus said.
My God.
The Holy Ghost just don't come to preach about money.
Come on.
Do you hear me? But the Holy Ghost comes to remind him what Jesus said. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
The ministry needs to be about Jesus. Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. When the Holy Ghost begins to preach, he's going to point back to Jesus.
Yeah.
Do you hear me? He don't come to speak on his own. He don't come to do his own thing. But he come to lift up Jesus.
Yeah.
And Jesus said, when the Holy Ghost comes, he said, he's going to testify of me. He said, the Holy Spirit is going to glorify me.
Oh, yeah.
The Holy Ghost is going to point you back to Jesus. And when the Holy Ghost points you back to Jesus, Jesus is going to point you to the Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
That's why Jesus said, I am the door. He said, if you want to get to the Father, he said, come through the door. He said, I am the way to the Father. I am the truth to the Father. He said, I am the life. But you want to get there through the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Do you hear me?
Yeah.
Let me show you something. The Father does not speak of himself. The Son, Jesus, do not speak of himself. The Holy Ghost do not speak of himself. What will happen is that the Holy Spirit will point to Jesus. And then Jesus will turn around and point to the Father. You hear me say to God? They don't boast about themselves. See, you got to understand the character of God. Do you hear me? He's all powerful, but yet he's so meek. Do you hear me?
Yes.
But the Holy Ghost points to Jesus. And Jesus points to the Heavenly Father. You can't know the Heavenly Father unless you come through Jesus. Do you hear me?
Yes.
And you can't know Jesus unless you come through the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit comes to bring to our remembrance the things that Jesus said. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Oh, my God. He comes to teach us all things. Oh, my God. If you need to be taught, the Holy Ghost will teach you.
Yes.
Go to Luke, the 4th chapter. Let's get on into this. Because I want you to understand what the Holy Spirit brings. I want you to understand, saints of God, what we are missing out on a whole lot of times in the house of God. I want you to understand what we are missing out on as people of God and children of God. When we quench the Holy Spirit, I want you to know what you're missing out on. When you grieve the Holy Spirit, I want you to know what you're missing out on. You have to understand what the Holy Spirit brings into the house of God and what the Holy Spirit brings into your own personal life. Do you hear me, saints of God? I want the Holy Spirit moving in my personal life. Do you hear me, saints of God? Look at Luke, the 4th chapter, verse 18. This is what the Spirit of God brings. Oh, my God. Shunda, the whole shunda. Yes, Lord. Oh, my God. Thank you, Jesus. The Holy Spirit brings the anointing. Do you hear me? Look what Jesus said after he had been baptized, after he came out the wilderness from fasting. Jesus walked into the house of God.
Yeah.
He picked up the Bible and opened it. And look what he said. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. One thing that the Holy Spirit brings to the house of God and one thing the Holy Spirit brings to the saints of God is that he will anoint you to preach the gospel to the poor. Do you hear me? We need the Holy Ghost when we're preaching. We don't need to preach or teach without the Holy Ghost. Do you hear me, saints of God? We don't shout the Holy Ghost when we're preaching and teaching. Sometimes I get up with the Word of God and I'm thinking I'm going to go this direction and God takes me a whole different direction. You know why? Because God is testing you. God says you're going to do things my way or you're going to do things your way. But he said the anointing of God is on me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. Something else that the Holy Ghost does and the anointing does, it flows and heals the brokenhearted. This is when you come into the house of God and you got a broken heart. You got a heart that's been broken in pieces. When you come into the house of God, the Spirit of God will begin to flow and will begin to speak through that man or woman of God, and God will begin to heal your broken heart.
Nobody even know that your heart is broken. But when you come into the house of God, God revealed to that man or that woman of God that you're dealing with a broken heart. And when the anointing is flowing, and when the Holy Spirit is flowing, and the Holy Spirit is speaking, guess what? God will heal a broken heart.
Oh yeah.
We got to understand what the Holy Ghost brings to the house of God. It's the Holy Ghost that will tell you that man dealing with a broken heart. It's the Holy Ghost that will tell you that woman is dealing with a bruise and they've been having her in bondage for 15 to 20 years. It's the Holy Ghost, do you hear me, that will heal a broken heart. And I need the Holy Spirit flowing in my life so God can heal a broken heart. This is how Pastor Ellen's heart had been healed when it had been broken, because I had a relationship with God, and through the Holy Ghost, God been teaching me, and God began to heal my broken heart.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is the reason why, because you got to understand what the Holy Spirit brings to your life, do you hear me? That drinking ain't going to do it. That smoking ain't going to do it. That relationship ain't going to do it. But you need the Spirit of God.
Oh,
you
yeah.
need the anointing of God flowing in your life so God can heal a broken heart.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said that the Spirit of God is upon me because he has anointed me. He has consecrated me. Jesus said, I'm consecrated. He said, I'm set aside. He said, I'm smeared with the presence of God. Can you hear me say to God? Anointed means to smear. It means to rub oil on me. You hear me say to God? All I want to be rubbed and smeared with the presence of God. God put it all in my head, God. Put it all in my heart. Do you hear me say to God? I want to be rubbed. I want to be smeared with the anointing of God. All I want the Holy Ghost all over me.
Yes.
I want the Holy Ghost all in my house.
Yes.
You hear me say, God, all I need the Holy Ghost. He said that the Spirit of God is
upon me. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor.
Yes,
he has sent me to heal those who are brokenhearted. And say, so God, all in the house of God, we need the ministry of the Holy Ghost flowing.
Yes.
That when people come in, their broken heart can't be mended. Do you hear me? My broken heart got meaning in the house of God. Oh, when I heard that word come forth,
yes,
and I heard that man of God preaching, and I heard that woman of God preaching, and I felt the anointing of God flowing, God began to heal my broken heart. God began to deal with the secret things that was in my heart. I'm talking about things that were deep down in the recesses of my heart. The Holy Ghost will reach all the way down and bring stuff up from the roof. Do you hear me? Because the anointing is flowing.
Hallelujah. Yes.
I want to sit up on an anointed teacher.
Yes, yes.
I want to sit up on a teacher that the word of God goes down inside my heart. That God is reading my thoughts and reading my intentions.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That God is telling me how I'm feeling, which direction I'm going to get ready to go. Do you hear me say, God? All the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, but they're ordered through the Holy Spirit. Send me to heal the broken hearted.
Oh, yes.
If you know that God has sent you to heal the broken hearted.
Oh, yes.
I'm talking about people with broken hearts, but you can't go forth and minister to people with broken hearts if your heart's still broken.
Come on.
But when the anointing is there,
yeah.
I can tell you in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy.
Hey, God.
Do you hear me say, see God?
Yeah.
Because I'm not walking around like I got a limit inside my mouth. Because I've been in God's presence for real. Do you hear me say, see God? All I've been healed in his presence. Do you hear me say, see God? It's in his presence, there is fullness of joy.
Yeah.
It's in the presence of God. It's when the anointing of God is flowing that the broken heart is healed.
Yes, yes, yes.
Don't quench the Spirit of God. Because your broken heart will never be healed.
My God.
Don't you quench the Spirit of God.
Mm.
Because healing will not manifest.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
He has sent me to heal the broken heart.
Uh-huh.
To preach deliverance to the captive.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit comes to empower us to preach deliverance to the captive.
Yes, Lord.
I'm talking about those who are captive.
Yes, Lord.
I'm talking about those who the enemy have caught and they got and the enemy got them in fellas.
Yeah.
I'm talking about those that the enemy of God have that the enemy have caught and they got feathers on their feet. I'm talking about those who are yoked up with certain people and can't break away.
Come
I'm talking
on.
About those
yes,
who are tied up with soul ties. See, when you come into the house of God, the anointing of God and the Spirit of God will loose those who are captive.
Yeah, yeah.
When you begin to preach upon the anointing, you begin to tell people you're free. Because he said the anointing come, the Spirit of God is upon me so I can preach deliverance to the captives. Well, God began to tell you that you're free.
You're free.
If you get up on the blood, God said you're free.
You're free.
If you trust in Jesus, God said that you're free. He said you don't understand that stronghold.
God said
the burden is already lifted. If you cry out to Jesus. For whosoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Yes,
I am anointed to tell you that you are free.
Hallelujah.
He has anointed me to preach deliverance to the captives.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God. If you're captive, and something have you captive, come into the house of God. So the Spirit of God can speak so you can understand that you are free.
Yes, Lord.
Deliverance to the captive. Recover of sight to the blind. Those who are blind. Listen, the Spirit of God will open up your eyes to see and liberty of them that are bruised. People whose hearts are bruised. When the anointing of God is flowing, and when the Spirit of God is really speaking in the house of God, God will sit and liberty those who are bruised, those who have a bruised heart. I can't sit in the house and all the thing we talking about is sowing and reaping and talking about money. Do you hear me say to God? Because we got too many people coming in from the streets that's bruised. We got too many people coming into the house of God and their heart is broken. We got too many people coming into the house of God and they're thinking about committing suicide. And they say, God, if I go into your house and that man don't say nothing to me, I'm going to go home and kill myself. Oh, you need the Spirit of God. You need men and women of God who can see in the Spirit. Oh,
yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. To hear the hearts of those who are bruised.
Thank you, Jesus.
And that's how we need the Holy Spirit flowing in our lives.
Oh, yes.
So God can heal a bruised heart.
Amen.
The anointing.
Yeah.
Is the Holy Spirit flowing in your life?
Yeah.
When the Holy Spirit is flowing in your life. I say flowing. I'm not talking about some little bitty drops. I'm talking about the Holy Spirit flowing. When the Spirit of God is teaching in your life, do you hear me? That's the anointing of God flowing. When the Holy Spirit is leading you and guiding you, that's the Spirit of God flowing.
Yes.
But he said, the Spirit of God is upon me. Showing you what the Holy Ghost brings.
Yeah.
Oh my God. He brings deliverance to the captive.
Oh, yeah.
The Holy Ghost brings healing to those who have a broken heart. The Holy Ghost bring recover of sight to the blind. And he said, at liberty to them that are bruised. That's why the Bible said, where the Spirit of the Lord is, that there is liberty. Do you hear me saying to God? If God's Spirit is in a house, you can get free.
Yes, Lord.
But we also can reject the movement of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Oh, my God.
Hallelujah.
Go to Acts chapter 1. My God. Acts chapter 1.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Let me show you what else the Holy Ghost bring. We dealt with this last Wednesday, but I want to deal with it again. I want you to get it down in your spirit. Acts chapter 1, verse 8. Something that the Holy Ghost brings to the church and brings to your personal life. See, you ain't going to quench the Holy Spirit now. Because I see what he brings to my life. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. The best person to listen to is the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But you shall receive power. Yes, Lord. There you go.
Power.
After the Holy Ghost has come upon you.
Yeah.
And you should be witness unto me both in Jerusalem and Judea and Samaria and the uttermost part of the earth. Uh-huh. He said, when you receive the Holy Ghost, what else do the Holy Ghost bring? The Holy Ghost brings dunamis. He brings dynamite power. He brings power.
Power.
Do you hear me?
Power.
He brings God's might. When the Holy Ghost comes, he brings God's might.
Hey.
When the Holy Ghost comes, he brings God's ability.
Yes.
When the Holy Ghost comes, he brings God's energy. This is the reason why come you need the Holy Ghost, you need dunamis, you need dynamite power.
Oh, yeah.
Do you hear me say to God?
Yeah.
All your expectation would ignite dynamite power. Just like it takes a flame to light a stick of dynamite, it takes expectation to light the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
And sometimes we come into the house of God, but we don't have no expectation. But when you got expectation and you come into the house of God, when you come into the house of God and you charge in your spirit and you begin to lift your hands up and you begin to magnify God, you begin to get everything out your mind. Because right now I'm running and riding everybody else on your mind. But you come into the house of God, you got to clear everything out your mind. You got to come with some expectation and say, God, I'm going to get healed today. I'm going to get delivered today. I'm going to get set free today. God, I'm going to get restored. I'm going to get direction today. You hear me say to God, you got to come into the house of God with expectation in your heart if you want dunamis power to be released.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh my God. Dunamis power is God's might. It's God's ability. It's God's energy. It's God's deed showing power. Do you hear me say to God? Dunamis power is power to achieve. What you couldn't achieve at first, you can't achieve it now because you got Holy Ghost power.
Yes.
You got dunamis power.
Yes.
Do you hear me say to God? I can get up and preach because I got Holy Ghost power.
Yeah.
I'm not shaking when I get up. You know why? Because I trust in God because I know he's going to give me dunamis power.
Yes.
Do you hear me say to God? I can power and I will power and I am able power. Why? Because I got Holy Ghost power.
Yeah, Holy Ghost.
You can live right when you understand you got dunamis power.
Hey, God.
You can hear me saying, God, you can walk in the midst of people who can't stand you, but you got dunamis power.
Hey.
It's not my power. It's not my might. It's not my will. So do you hear me saying, God, but it's dunamis power.
Dunamis
people
power.
Are looking at the wrong one. You need to be looking at the Holy Ghost because he brings to the church dunamis power.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Miraculous power. When the Holy Ghost comes, he comes to bring power.
Mm-hmm.
How are we now walking in dunamis power when the Holy Ghost is in the house?
Mm-hmm.
How are we now walking in dunamis power when the Holy Ghost lives down on the inside of us?
Mm-hmm.
You got to understand, saints of God, that if you are filled with the Holy Ghost, that you are carrying dunamis power.
Yeah.
He comes to bring mm-hmm. dunamis power.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. Thank you, Jesus. Go to 1 Corinthians. I'm going to show you something else that he brings to the church. I'm going to show you something that he brings to us individually. 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter. Oh, my God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Mm.
Good timing. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter.
Thank you.
Because we don't know all the things that the Holy Spirit brings.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, my God. Mm. Look at 1 Corinthians, chapter 12.
Uh-huh.
Verse 4. Now there are what?
Diversities of gifts.
Diversities of gifts.
Uh-huh.
But the same Spirit. Which means that the Holy Ghost brings the gifts of the Spirit into the house of God.
Uh-huh.
And into the saints of God. There are differences of administration, but the same Lord.
Uh-huh.
And there are diversities of operations, but it is the same God which works all in all.
Uh-huh.
But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit everybody.
Yes, profit all.
Okay, keep reading here. To profit everybody.
Mm-hmm.
For to one is given by the Spirit, by the Holy Spirit, the word of wisdom. To another, the word of knowledge.
Uh-huh.
To another, gifts of healing.
Uh-huh.
To another, faith. To another, working of miracles. Do you hear me say to God?
Uh-huh.
These are all gifts of the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
The Holy Spirit brings all these gifts into the house of God.
Yeah.
To another, tongues.
Mm-hmm.
To another, interpretation of tongues. To another, discerning of spirits. All these gifts are for the children of God.
Yes.
Why are we not seeing these gifts flow into the house of God? You know why? Because we have quenched the Spirit of God.
Yes, my God.
He
my
said
God.
All gifts is given for the profit of all.
Profit
if
of
you
all.
Got a gift from the Holy Spirit, it's for the profit of everybody else in the house of God.
Yes.
This is the reason I come when the word of knowledge is flowing. The word of knowledge comes to let a person know what's going on in your life right then.
Mm-hmm.
And when a person begins to speak, they begin to give you a word of knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thus says the Lord. Da 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 is going on right now. You know that they don't know. Okay, right then, that's the word of knowledge flowing.
Uh-huh.
The word of wisdom begins to flow. The word of wisdom is when a man of God or a woman of God is giving you wisdom about that particular situation.
Yes.
Do you hear me say to God? Discerning of spirits. Well, when God began to show us what's behind what a person said.
Uh-huh.
God began to show you the Spirit. Do you hear me? These are people who know when the enemy is at work and when it's not God.
Yes.
You got people who got the gifts of healing.
Mm-hmm.
Do you hear me? The working of miracles.
Mm-hmm.
Tongues. Interpretation of tongues. All these flow through the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Do you hear me? Thanks to God.
Yes.
This is the reason why we need to understand what the Holy Spirit brings. Because the Holy Spirit brings the gifts of God to the house of God.
Yeah. Yes, Lord.
But if we quench the Holy Spirit, the enemy says, God don't heal no more.
Uh-huh.
And those gifts don't flow no more.
Uh-huh.
Why is he doing that? Because he knows if I can shut down the gifts
uh-huh.
of the Holy Spirit, I can shut down people getting healed in the house of God.
Uh-huh.
Because they don't believe that God will heal no more.
Yeah.
I can shut down the working of miracles
yeah.
because they don't believe that God performs miracles anymore.
Yeah.
Therefore, he can shut down the flow of the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
But we have to understand that the gifts of the Spirit, the Spirit of God brings the gifts. If we're going to speak in tongues, the Spirit of God has to bring the gifts.
Yes, Lord.
He brings the gifts of the Spirit.
Hallelujah.
We got to seek God. God, what gifts you want me to flow in?
What gifts, God?
Or what gifts do you want me to flow in?
Yeah.
Do you hear me saying to God?
Mm.
These are not talents.
Mm.
We can't just walk in these gifts and we get ready.
Come on.
The Holy Ghost has to empower us at that time to carry out a particular gift. Do you hear me saying
yes,
to God?
Yes.
But the Holy Spirit
my God.
Brings the gifts of the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Go to Galatians chapter 5. Because I want to really minister on this because sometimes in the house of God, we love the gifts of the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
We love the showy stuff.
Yes, Lord.
And this is what gets us in trouble.
Yeah.
But we got to understand that the Spirit of God just does not bring the anointing and the gifts of the Spirit. He also brings something else.
Mm-hmm.
Look at Galatians chapter 5. Thank you, Jesus. Mm-hmm. Verse 22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. Do you hear me? Now what he said, first verse 16 of that same chapter, he said, I say to you then, walk in the Spirit, and you should not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Something else that the Spirit of God brings to the house of God and to the saints of God, he brings the fruit of the Spirit. What is the fruit of the Spirit? The fruit of the Spirit is the deeds of the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
It's the character of the Spirit. It's the actions of the Spirit.
Yes.
Do you hear the saints of God?
Yes.
When the Holy Ghost really is on down inside of you, you don't have the character of God.
Yes.
You can't tell me that you got the Holy Ghost and you don't got God's character.
Come on,
saints of God.
Yes, Lord.
Oh no, we're not going to teach people nothing like that. Mm-hmm. Because if the Spirit of God is there, the fruit of the Spirit, the character of God is going to be there. What? The fruit of the Spirit, one part of it is love. And this is why I think we got a problem right here.
Yeah.
It's because we trying to love without the Holy Spirit. You can't love without the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
When God tell you to love your enemies, guess what? Woo. You can't love your enemies without the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit comes to bring the fruit of the Spirit.
Yes,
and we said, asking God, teach me how to love, man, and show me how to love. Right. You need to check and see if the Spirit of God lives inside of you.
Yes.
Because let me tell you something. You cannot manifest the love out of your flesh.
My God.
You got to get that through the Holy Ghost. And you can't get there if you don't know how to shut your mouth when the Spirit of God is telling you to shut up.
Yeah.
You hear the saints of God? God is trying to enable you to love somebody, but you keep going off on them.
My God.
The Spirit of God just don't bring the gifts. But he also brings the fruit.
Yes.
In the house of God, everybody likes the gifts. I want to see the Spirit of God move. We seeing the gifts. We seeing the showy stuff. But what about the fruit of the Spirit?
What about
loving God with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and loving our neighbors ourselves?
Yes.
You hear me, saints of God?
Yes.
That takes Holy Ghost power.
You
can't even walk in love without Holy Ghost power.
Yeah.
Do you hear me? We trying to love without Holy Ghost power, but God will ask you to love them through me.
Love them through me, God.
That's what I ask God. Love my wife through me.
Yeah.
I don't want it to be my love.
Yeah.
Because my love is fickle, do you hear me? My love is sometimes, when you deal with that fleshly love and that human love, guess what? You'll get in some trouble. That's that human love that wake up and say, I don't love you anymore, and I just don't feel it anymore. I'm scared of a person who walk in that human love.
Yeah.
But I want to be with a person who got the fruit of the Spirit.
Yeah.
I'm talking about that agape kind of love.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about that love that's based on feelings.
Uh-huh.
But I'm talking about the agape kind of love.
Yeah.
I'm talking about that kind of love that's based on your decision.
Lord, thank you.
Agape love is love based on decision. It don't got nothing to do with my feelings. Agape love means to have goodwill towards a person. It means to choose to love them even when they done me wrong. You can't do that with your flesh. You can't do that with your human nature. All that worrying for somebody. Because it's somebody on your job that you having a hard time loving right now. But when the Holy Ghost, when you let him take the reins, when you let him get in the driver's seat, the Holy Ghost will love him through you. Do you hear me, saints of God? All you need is the Holy Ghost. And you need to understand that the Holy Ghost brings the love of God.
Hallelujah.
I feed my enemies.
Because
they got nothing to do with my feelings. This is not feeling your love. This is the agape love. It don't got nothing to do with how you feel. It got something to do with having goodwill towards people.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
I wish you goodwill. Even though you did me wrong.
Yeah.
When we say, I hope you leave here again, the car wreck and die, that's not agape. Do you hear me? But when you get agape love, you say, listen, I wish you well. God, I asked you to save them. But this is a process.
Yeah.
The Holy Ghost got to teach you to walk in this kind of love. Do you hear me say to God? It's already gone inside of you, but you got to tap into the Holy Ghost and let the Holy Ghost lead you so you can walk in agape.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
The Holy Ghost comes to bring the fruit. In the church, we don't want to talk about the fruit. Let's talk about the gifts. Let's not talk about the fruit. Let's talk about the power of God. Let's not talk about the fruit.
Because when we begin to talk about the fruit, that means that we got to live like God.
Uh-huh.
When we begin to talk about the fruit, that means we got to have the same character
yes.
of God.
Yes,
the peace of God.
The peace of God.
He said, love, joy, peace, something that you cannot get without the Spirit of God is joy.
Mm-hmm.
In the flesh, you can get happy.
Uh-huh.
Happy means something got to happen
yes.
before we get happy.
Mm-hmm.
But the Holy Ghost comes and brings joy.
Joy.
I've been running on joy for so many years now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you hear me? Joy means gladness.
Yeah.
Don't nothing good got to be going on. It been times that things was not going right in our life and I still had joy.
Yeah, yeah.
You know why? Because joy comes from the Holy Ghost.
Yes,
joy does not come because I got a new car.
Uh-huh.
Joy does not come because I got a new house.
Come on.
Because if the house is taken and if the car is taken, if it's based on that, it's going to leave out the door.
Yeah, yeah,
but
yeah.
joy comes from the presence of God.
Yes,
that's what the Bible says in the presence of the Lord.
Oh.
I'm giving you scripture. There is fullness of joy. And what a lot of us need right now, we just need some joy. Because the Bible said that the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Yes.
If you want some strength, get some joy.
Hey,
some of us don't got no strength because we don't got no joy.
Yeah.
This is when the enemy come and hit you, you go straight down.
My God.
Yeah. The enemy hit you in the stomach, you go straight down. Oh, you don't got no strength. You don't got no strength to pray. You don't got no script to trust God. You don't got no script to study your word. You don't got no script to meditate on your word. You don't got no script to fast. You just don't got no strength. Do you hear me? But when you get the joy of God, when that fruit of the Spirit called joy really hit your belly, guess what? You get strength to do stuff that you couldn't do at first. Joy. A merry heart does good like a medicine. Do you hear me? Thanks to God. Oh my God. But bitterness is rotten to the bone.
Oh, yeah.
When we walk in bitterness, that's because some people get arthritis because of bitterness.
Mm-hmm.
But when the Holy Ghost is there, he will show you how to walk in joy. This is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and be glad in it.
Yeah.
These are scriptures that the Holy Ghost will begin to bring up to you. When you get up in the morning, you need to make the declaration. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Yes.
I shall rejoice and be glad in it. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
We have to make a decision to walk in joy.
Yes,
it don't got nothing to do with your feelings. You got to make a decision to walk in joy.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes. Sometimes I wake up, I don't feel like walking in joy.
Mm.
It don't got nothing to do with the feelings. Do you hear me? But this is the day that the Lord has made. And since God made this day, my enemies didn't make this day. My circumstance didn't make this day. The pain I'm feeling in my body didn't make this day. My supervisor didn't make my day. Do you hear me say, God? This is the day that the Lord has made.
Yeah.
I shall rejoice and be glad in it. And you can't rejoice without joy.
My God.
So many sad saints. Like we got a limit in our mouth. Can't smile. Do you hear me? Thank you, God. You need the joy of God.
Yes.
You need the fruit of joy manifested in your life. Love, joy, peace. Do you hear me? Thank you, God. The peace of God. We can't walk in the peace of God without the Holy Ghost.
Oh, yes.
Do you hear me? Thank you, God.
Yes.
These are things that the Holy Ghost bring to your life. And I can't quench the Spirit of God because I need the peace of God flowing in my life.
Yes.
I need peace which surpasses all understanding. God said, if you keep your mind on me, I will keep you in perfect peace.
Uh-huh.
The Holy Ghost will tell you, keep your mind on God.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost will tell you, keep your mind on the Word.
Yes.
Thanks to God, what are your mind on as you're going through the day? Because if your mind is on anything else, you can't walk in the peace of God.
Yeah, yeah.
Your mind has to stay on the Word of God in order for you to walk in the peace of God.
My God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Peace.
Yes, Lord.
Which surpasses all understanding.
Yes, it all.
Long suffering.
No.
Which means patience. Some of us got no patience because the Holy Ghost is not there.
Yes.
Or we question the Holy Spirit when he's telling us to do certain things.
Yes.
God said, let them go ahead and get over. God said, let her go before you. Oh, yeah, he'll tell you to do it because God's trying to teach you patience.
Yes.
Oh, no, You walk in front. You cut in front of somebody. God trying to teach you patience. Do you hear me?
Yes.
It's through the leading of the Holy Ghost
yes.
that we begin to have the character of God.
Yes, Lord.
The peace of God. The long-suffering. When you begin to have patience, these are characteristics of the Holy Ghost. Long-suffering. Some of us don't have no patience with nobody. I'm talking about as soon as they do something, we wig out.
Yes.
because we don't got no long suffering.
Yes.
But when you let the Holy Ghost lead you, He will teach you to be patient. Mm-hmm. There were times I would drive down the road, and somebody driving too slow, I cut around.
Yeah.
Do you hear me? And more of them went on passing by, because you're going too slow. I'm just being truthful with you. But as time began to go on, God said, slow down. See, we think God ain't. We think the Spirit of God won't tell us to do stuff like that. He said, slow down. He said, maybe it's something up the road that happened. Sometimes God will put a person in front of you, and they'll be driving slow. And you be in a rush to get around them. But when you get up the road, you see it was an accident. God was covering you. That's why Thomas said, you need to listen to the Holy Spirit. Be here and say it to God. There is a reason why God is trying to teach you patience. We have to learn long suffering. Oh my God. Gentleness. Oh my God. A lot of us need that.
Oh yes.
Goodness. Oh my God.
Yay.
Some of us are not gentle. We're very rough. Oh, but the Spirit of God will bring gentleness.
Oh God.
Goodness is part of the fruit of the Spirit.
Yes.
If a person really saved, they're going to exemplify goodness and gentleness and patience, meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. These are the characteristics of the Holy Ghost.
Mm-hmm.
Now, since I'm saying I'm going to come to a close, go to Matthew the 7th chapter.
My God.
Because I want to speak to you about fruit.
Oh, Jesus.
We got 5 more minutes. My God. Look at Matthew the 7th chapter.
My God.
Verse 15 through 20. I want to speak to you about the fruit of the Spirit of God. He said, beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep clothing.
Yes.
But inwardly they are ravenous wolves.
Yes.
He said you should know them by their fruits.
Mm-hmm.
Do men gather grapes from thorns or figs from thistles? Even so, every good tree bring forth good fruit.
Yes.
But a corrupt tree bring forth evil fruit.
Mm-hmm.
A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit. Neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Do you hear me saying to God? Every tree that bring not forth good fruit is cut down and cast into the fire.
Yes.
Wherefore, by their fruits, you should know them.
Yes.
Jesus said, if you want to know if somebody is from me, he said, look at their fruits. Because the Holy Ghost is going to bring the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Do you hear me, saints of God?
Yes.
We can't say we're from God if we don't got the fruit.
Yes.
He said, the way that you can tell a false teacher, look at their fruit.
Mm-hmm.
The way you can tell a false prophet, look at their fruit. Don't go by what they prophesy. Go by how they live.
Yes.
Do you hear me, saints of God?
Yes.
Because if they really from God, they're going to have the fruit of God.
Yes, Lord.
Come on now. You can tell a tree by the fruit that it bears.
Yes, Lord.
I can tell if a person serving God by the fruit that they bear.
Come on.
Do you hear me? We got to get away from this in the house of God. Well, we just looking at gifts and we ain't looking at fruit.
Come on.
The enemy wants us concerned about gifts, but he don't want us looking at fruit. Because he understands that when you walk in fruit, you're going to have the character of God.
Yes, Lord.
We can't be moved by people's gifts. We have to be moved by fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Do you hear me, saints of God?
Yes, Lord.
Look at John chapter 15. John chapter 15. Still speaking about fruit. God wants us to produce fruit.
My God.
We can't be a church that don't produce fruit.
Come on.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. John 15, verse 1 and 2. I'm going to take off. Jesus said, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husband, the vine dresser. He said, every branch in me that bear not fruit, he take away.
Mm-hmm.
And every branch that bear fruit, he prune it.
Mm-hmm.
That he may bring forth more fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus said, I am the true vine. The branches are connected to the vine.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He said, every branch in me that don't bring forth fruit, he said, God gonna cut it off. Some people playing with God, they don't got no fruit, can't even tell they serve God. God said, the time gonna come, I'm gonna cut you off.
My God.
Do you hear me? He said, I'm the true vine.
True vine.
Which means you got to be in me before you can bear fruit.
My God.
If any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. All things pass away, behold, all things have become new. We can't be a branch inside of Jesus and don't bear fruit. We can't say that we really connected to Jesus and don't bear fruit. Because if you connected to Jesus, you're going to bear fruit.
Oh, yes.
We can't say that we connected to Jesus and hate our brother and our sister. You ain't doing nothing but lying.
Oh, yes.
The Bible says, how can you say that you love God whom you have not seen? But hate your brother who you see. Hate
yes.
your sister who you see. You hate their guts, but somehow you love God. The Bible says you ain't nothing but a liar and the truth ain't in you.
Yes.
Do you hear me saying to God? We got to make sure that we are bearing fruit.
Hallelujah.
That the love of God is flowing in our hearts.
My God.
We got to get this right about the fruit of God. God gave me a dream a couple of weeks ago about the rapture. And in the rapture, I saw people being taken up. And God showed me in my heart how it will feel to be left behind.
Oh my God.
I'm talking about the feeling that I felt of him showing me of people being left behind. Because Jesus is coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And we as the saints of God, we're dancing around the church and concerned about gifts. But I hear Paul saying, I show you a more excellent way.
He said,
you're concerned about gifts. He said, but I want you to walk in love.
Yes,
do you hear me?
Yes.
Because God's not coming back for a gifted church. He's coming back for a fruitful church. Do you hear me? He's coming back for a church that look just like him. And if we don't look like Jesus, when he come back, he's going to leave us. Do you hear me, saints of God? Because we will not go into the presence of God without the fruit of God.
My God.
It don't mean nothing because we prophesy.
Boy.
It don't mean nothing. I don't care nothing about no preaching. You think I'm concerned about preaching? God can take the preaching. But God, give me your presence.
Help me
to walk in the fruit of the Spirit of God.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I'm concerned about the fruit. I'm not concerned about the gifts of healing and the word of knowledge and the discerning of spirits and tongues and interpretation of tongues and anointing and the power of God. No, I'm concerned about the love of God.
Yes,
I'm concerned about the fruit of God.
My God.
Love. Oh, my God. It's a trademark. When God come back, he see you, he said, that one is mine. And we can't do it without the Holy Ghost.
Yeah, God.
Do you hear me? Every branch of me that don't bear fruit, he said, I'm going to cut it off. He said, right now you connected to me. He said, but you ain't bearing fruit. He said, listen, God is patient with us. God give us time to bring forth fruit.
Yeah.
He said, but if you don't bring forth fruit in a proper timing, I'm going to cut your branch. And some people's branch have been cut. We heard the woman of God, and woman to woman, the woman had a heart attack. Wrecked on the spot. Eyes got the roll in the back of her head. She said, I don't even know if I would have been ready. Do you hear me? Thanks to God. Because death can hit you just like that. You thinking that you got so much time. I don't know why I'm going here, but I'm going here. You think that you got so much time, and you don't got to bear no fruit, and you don't got to do what God says. But I'm telling you, God said, I will cut your branch and throw it into the fire. Which means God said, I will cut you off, and you'll be cast into hell. Why? Because God said, you ain't bearing no fruit.
My God. Yeah, you don't know.
Branch is connected to the vine. He said, you can't do nothing without the vine. Do you hear me? He said, you got to be good. Stop trying to do it on your own and let God do it through you. Stop trying to love and walk in joy and peace on your own and let God do it through you. Say, God, you do it through me. But when God do it through you, listen to what God say. God said, be quiet, don't say nothing. Because God trying to teach you how to be patient. God trying to teach you how to study to be quiet. Do you hear me? But we keep quenching the Spirit of God. When God said do something, God said go right, we go left. God said don't go over there, we still go over. You know why? Because we quenching the Spirit of God. And we wonder how come we are not more Christ-like. Because you want to do what the Holy Ghost say.
Yeah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
He said, I'm going to cut you off. If you ain't bearing fruit.
Jesus.
But every tree that bears fruit, he's not going to prune you. These are the ones who are exemplifying the character of God.
Jesus.
God's not going to prune you. Prune means to cut back. Those branches that grow out that's old, God's not going to cut out the old branches. He's not going to cut stuff off you so you can bring forth more fruit.
Yes.
Do you hear the saints of God?
Yes.
He said, the ones bearing fruit, I'm going to cut the stuff off that you don't need so you can bring forth more fruit.
Yes.
It hurts sometimes when God prune you.
Thank you,
God said, stop hanging around him. Because evil company corrupts good habits.
Yes.
So God cut off old friends. He's pruning you.
Thank
Do you hear me? God said, keep the mouth closed. God said, you talk too much and you get around people.
Thank
That's
you.
Why in the multitude of words, sin is not lacking. But David said, I will keep my mouth closed when I'm before the wicked.
When I'm before
wicked people, when I talk too much. You know why? Because in the multitude of words, sin is not lacking. You're going to say something dumb. When I get around people that I know that's my enemy, I won't say too much. When I get around people I don't know, I won't say too much. You know why? Because a wise man conceals knowledge.
Yes.
A foolish man pours out foolishness. A wise man will be quiet and won't even tell you what he know.
Hey, God. Yeah.
There are times me and wife been around men of God, great men and women of God, and I wouldn't say nothing.
Ooh.
And they be talking the word, and I be sitting there, amen, man of God, amen. Well, I'm sitting there learning. But then, next thing you know, they see God use me and so forth. They say, young man, why weren't you saying nothing? God put all that word inside you. They say, why didn't you bring up nothing? Because I'm being quiet.
Yeah.
I'm around great men and women of God, and I'm learning how to be quiet.
Yeah.
I just want to sit back and receive. Mm-hmm. They don't mean that I don't say anything, but I'm sitting back and receiving. Mm-hmm. You hear the saints of God?
Yes. My God.
I want God to prune.
Yeah.
I want God to cut away everything that I don't need.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God. Thank you, Jesus. I'll give you some wisdom.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Mm.
Oh my God.
Hmm. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Abide in me, and I in you.
Mm-hmm.
As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself. You can't bear this kind of fruit of yourself. Look at verse 4. Except it be in the vine, no more can you except you abide in me.
Mm-hmm.
I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abide in me and I in him, the same bring forth much fruit.
Mm-hmm.
For without me, you can do nothing.
You can do
Stop
nothing.
Trying to do it on your own. Go to Mark, last one, Mark 11 chapter.
Mm-hmm.
Saints of God, we got to bear the fruit of God.
Yes.
We can't be walking around hating each other talking about we the church.
Oh God.
Can't be walking around talking about each other talking about we the church.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't nobody finna talk about you to me. It ain't finna happen. I'm going to cut them off. This is my brother. This is my sister.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care what they're doing. I'm going to keep on praying for them. Do you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not cracking up no conversation around nobody about my brother or my sister.
Mm-hmm.
Do you hear me, saints of God?
Mm-hmm.
Because Jesus said, by this men will know you are my disciples when you love the brother. The word is not going to know that we are disciples of Jesus unless we love one another.
Come on.
Do you hear me?
Yes,
Mark,
Lord.
The 11th chapter.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. Verse 11. And Jesus entered into Jerusalem and to the temple. And when he looked around about upon all things, and now the evening time was come. And he went out of Bethany with the 12 disciples.
Mm-hmm.
And on the morning when they were come from Bethany, he was hungry.
Mm-hmm.
And seeing a fig tree afar off having leaves, he came to it.
Mm-hmm.
If happily he may find anything on it, if he could find some fruit on it. It was a fig tree.
Mm-hmm.
And when he came to it, he found nothing but leaves.
Uh-huh.
For the time of figs would not yet come. And Jesus answered and said unto the tree, no man is going to eat fruit from you no more forever.
Mm-hmm.
And his disciples heard it. Why did Jesus curse the tree? It was a fig tree.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus was hungry. He went up to the tree to see if it had any fruit on it. It was a fig tree. It had leaves. But when he got to it and looked on the leaves, he didn't see no fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Now look now, the Bible says that it wasn't time for figs.
Yes. Yes.
Now somebody said, if it wasn't time for figs, they said, how come Jesus cursed the tree and it wasn't time for figs?
Yeah.
It wasn't time for the fruit to grow.
Uh-huh.
But you got to understand something about a fig tree.
Mm.
A fig tree, before the fig really grow and get mature, it have little bitty buds on it.
Uh-huh.
These little bitty buds, you can pick and eat because they still fruit, do you hear me?
Uh-huh.
It's supposed to have little bitty buds on it.
Mm-hmm.
It's supposed to have little bitty fruit on it. Do you hear me? But when Jesus made it to it, he didn't see nothing but leaves.
Uh-huh.
He didn't see no fruit, so Jesus cursed the tree because he said, listen, really, you perpetrate.
Uh-huh.
You got the leaves, but you don't got the fruit.
Hey.
Do you hear me, saints of God? We got the showy stuff. We got the leaves. Because when the wind blow, the leaves begin to rattle.
Uh-huh.
We got this showy stuff, do you hear me?
Yeah.
But Jesus said, I'm not looking for the leaves. I'm not looking for this showy stuff.
Yeah, yeah,
he said,
yeah.
I'm looking for some fruit out your life.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, if I don't see no fruit in your life, he said, I'm going to cut off the branch.
Yeah.
And saints of God, this is the reason why I come. We need the Holy Ghost flowing in our life.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I want fruit growing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
When God come and check my life, I at least want him to see a little love.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I told you that tree supposed to have little buds.
Uh-huh.
Little pieces of fruit.
Uh-huh.
That you can take off and bite and eat into. Do you hear me? When Jesus come, I want him to see me having a little patience.
Look.
Do you hear me? When Jesus come and look on your tree, what is he going to see? Is he going to see the leaves blowing? Is he going to see gifts flowing? When Jesus come back for the church, what is he going to see? We're not preparing people to see Jesus. We're not preparing people to go to heaven. We ain't even talking about heaven. We ain't even talking about hell.
Uh-uh.
We talking about a mansion after on the sea.
Come on.
We talking about money. Ain't nobody preparing people to see God. Do you hear me?
Yeah,
ain't
yeah.
nobody talking about the new heaven, new earth, and the new Jerusalem.
Come on.
Ain't nobody preparing the saints of God to go see Jesus. But Jesus coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle.
Yes. Yeah.
He's coming back for a church that's being led by the Spirit of God.
Come on.
He's coming back for a church that got the fruit of God. Do you hear me? Saints of God, you can't do it on your own. You need the Spirit of God.
Need the Spirit of God. Thank you, Jesus.
And you need to understand what the Spirit of God brings.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
You can't be delivered without the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah.
Your heart will not be healed without the flow of the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah.
And the anointing of God. Do you hear me, saints of God?
Hallelujah.
Stop trying to do it on your own. Stop trying to love on your own. Stop trying to flow in the things of God on your own.
Yes,
and
Lord.
Say, God, do it through me.
Do it through me, God.
I surrender, God. Come on, baby. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I surrender.
Hallelujah.
I surrender to the moving of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.